Okay. Conservative or non-conservative force? To answer the question whether force is conservative or non-conservative, we can take into account these various equivalent conditions for force to be conservative. One is that it's path independent. Now, to show that a force is conservative by showing that it's path independent would mean that you would need to show that the integral over any path is the same, the integral between any two points is the same no matter what path you take between those two points. That can be a challenging proof, and we're probably not going to use that characteristic simply because it requires more sophisticated use of path integrals than we can assume in a course with a prerequisite of only one year of calculus. We have to use techniques from multivariable calculus. We don't want to develop those in the course, and we can't assume that you come to the course with them. Okay, another, the integral around any closed path is zero. Now, we can use either this or this to show that a force or a function is non-conservative. Okay, we can pick a path, and if the integral around the closed path is zero, then it is non-zero, then we can conclude that the force is not conservative. Okay, another is that the curl is zero. The questions about what the curl is, well, that's a multivariable calculus concept. So I'm going to talk about that because people kind of ask me to, because most of the class is taking multivariable calculus, but that's not going to be a required part of this course. So if you're not taking multivariable calculus and don't completely understand what I'm going to tell you about the curl a little bit later, you don't have to do it. You don't have to use it. And another is the force is the gradient of a potential function. Now, the gradient concept is a multivariable calculus concept, but it is included in your text in the discussion of conservative and non-conservative forces, so I am going to talk about that. Now, I started to try to give you a general result. I'm going to give you that result, but in class, as I started to do it, it began to occur to me that I was going to have to use concepts and ideas that you might not be totally familiar with, so I kind of abandoned that. And we went on to show that a certain force is non-conservative. The force would be y times I, and we proved that that's non-conservative. So I'm going to digress to a little more discussion, particularly about what a gradient means, and then probably in a separate video show a little bit about what the curl is and what that tells you about a function.